نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة حتى تركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله تبارك وتعالى وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Verily, all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him and we seek His aid. We ask refuge in Allah from the evils of ourselves and the evils of our actions. Whomsoever Allah guide, none can lead astray. And whomsoever went astray, none can guide. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His slave and messenger. O you who believes in Allah, fear Allah in the way who should be feared, and I not except in the state of Islam, with full and complete submission to Allah. O you mankind, be dutiful to your Lord, who created you from a single person, that is Adam alayhi salam, and from him he created his wife, and from both of them he created many men and many women. Be dutiful to your Lord, from whom you demand your mutual rights. Keep tight relationship with your relatives, especially the kinship, verily Allah is ever watcher upon you, O you who believe in Allah. Fear Allah and say the truth. He will rectify your deeds and he will forgive your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger will achieve a great achievement. The best of the speech is the speech of Allah Azza wa Jal, and the best of guidance is the guidance of our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the worst of actions are the newly invented matters in Islam, where every newly invented matter in Islam is innovation in Islam. And every innovation in Islam is misguidance, and every misguidance will lead to the hellfire. My brothers and sisters in Islam, that we should know as Muslims the purpose of our creation, that Allah Azza wa Jal has created us for a purpose, which is to worship Him Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And no believer in Allah Azza wa Jal, following the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, negate that. All of them confirmed that they worship none but Allah Azza wa Jal. And they try their best to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, we are in a time where things are changed. The definitions of things are changed. When you define Tawheed in the sight of some who claims to be Muslims, they will define it in a different way. And then they will say it's part of Tawheed to worship with Allah certain saints, certain people. They say part of their Tawheed of worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal, and the way to come close to Allah Azza wa Jal, to go to such and such shrine and worship them to get them closer to Allah Azza wa Jal, and they claim to be Muslims. And this is the time we are living. And we are living in a time that the sunnah in the sight of some Muslims, it is the pure bid'ah which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned against. And we are in a time that we define things of the wisdom behind them according to what we think they are wisdom behind them. When you say to someone, why do you pray the five daily prayer? They will say, to wake up in the morning, it is healthy for our body, and that's good for us. And as well, it will protect me from heart attack. it will do such and such, all of these things. And if you ask someone, why do you fast? They will say to you, I fast, you know, in order to get healthier, to be healthier, to get healthy body. I want to feel about the poor people and the needy ones. So the definition of things are corrupt in our mind. And that's why Islam came with a pure evidence, with a pure tawheed. And that's why when Allah Azza wa Jalla stated in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, I have not created the mankind nor the jinn kind except for my worship. أَيُّوَحِّدُونَ, to single out Allah Azza wa Jalla in the matters of worship. And this is the wisdom behind our creation, that Allah Azza wa Jalla created us for that purpose. The purpose that you are here, living on this earth, to submit your will to the will of your Lord. To submit your will to the will of your Lord. And to worship none but Him alone with no partners. And to seek Him out in the matters of worship, all kind of worship. And to follow the guidance of the prophets and messengers of Allah, ended with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the purpose behind your creation. So do not make anyone delude you and make you away, and make you think away from that purpose, or take you from that purpose. And as I said to you, we are living in a time that things are corrupt. Even definitions of ibadat, the act of worship, which is prescribed in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the definitions are changed in the sight of the Muslims. They are changed. And Islam, Allah Azza wa Jalla has sent it pure on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they practiced Islam, the pure Islam, which was revealed upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They practiced to the best of their ability. And my brothers and sisters, we should understand that the Tawheed of Islam are two parts. Tawheed of Islam are two parts. Firstly, Tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal. Tawheed of Allah Azza wa Jal. To single out Allah Azza wa Jal in the matters that befits His majesty and glory. Him alone with no partners. And that includes Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, which means to single out Allah Azza wa Jal in the matters of Lordship. That He is the creator. No one is a creator except Him, Tabarak wa Ta'ala, of this universe. And He is, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, the owner of everything. He owns everything in this universe, in His creation, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. He creates everything and He owns them, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And as well, that Allah Azza wa Jal, as will He control all affairs. Which means He is in charge of controlling all our affairs in this universe and in His creation, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And the second category of that, the second category of the first part, to single out Allah Azza wa Jalla in the matters of worship. To worship none but Allah alone with no partners. And all kind of worship has to be directed to Him, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And the third category of that is that Allah Azza wa Jalla has names and attributes that befits His majesty and glory, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So when we call Allah, or when we name Allah, it has to be the names that He has named Himself, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, with. Or what He has revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the second part of Tawheed, which is Tawheed al-Sunnah. Tawheed in following. Tawheed, following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Following the Prophet of Allah alayhi salatu wasalam. To follow Him alone alayhi salatu wasalam. That is His Sunnah. And leave anyone other than Him alayhi salatu wasalam. To leave all kind of people who are calling to different ways and follow His way, alayhi salatu wasalam. To single that, to single out His way, His methodology, alayhi salatu wasalam, in the matters of following, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And that's why Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he said about it. He said, those two types of tawheed, tawheed of Allah, and following the Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, these two types, there is no success. There is no success in the day of judgment except by following them. توحيد الله, which is to single out Allah Azza wa Jalla in the matters of worship. Then you will be away from the shirk and associating him with Allah partners. And the second type, that will be that if you follow the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, you will be away from bid'ah and innovations. And that's exactly the meaning of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. When we testify on a daily basis, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, you testify none worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And you testify that Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is his messenger, is the guide, for us alayhi salatu wassalam. And you cannot worship Allah Azza wa Jal except in His way, alayhi salatu wassalam. His way, His methodology. That is the only way to worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, we should understand that these matters are important for us to understand Islam. And that's why, in a time where the month of Ramadan is coming, wallahi, it hurts a lot when we explain to non-Muslims about the purpose of our fasting. Wallahi, it hurts our heart. It hurts our heart that someone explains Islam as if for in a pragmatic way. In a pragmatic way, meaning it is healthier, it is something that we think good about, it brings the community together. Subhanallah. What about if you, for example, for someone who even the people who are thinking about their health, what about if someone fasted for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal and he break his fast with unhealthy food? Is his fasting is valid? Yes, it is valid. It is best to have healthy food, but it doesn't mean his fasting is not valid. Or if someone, for example, to say, I feel about the poor people and the needy ones in the month of Ramadan. Subhanallah, when you see our feasts and iftar, when you see them, what kind of feeling about the needy ones? Subhanallah. Are our fasting are valid? Yes. Even if you have the massive feast, as long as you don't waste the food. Subhanallah. And or for example, bringing people together. What about if you stayed alone in the desert, somewhere on the mountain, and you fasted for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and worshipped Allah Azza wa Jalla, and no one was around you? And there is no community around you. Are your ibadah are valid? Yes. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to understand that the matters of Tawheed are important for our act of worship. And the true definitions of Islam are important to define things the way that Islam has defined it. The purpose of our fasting, to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. That is the pure act of worship for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And that is the pure definition. So when we define why we fast, to please Allah Azza wa Jalla. There are other good things comes with it. But the idea behind it and the wisdom behind it is to worship Allah Azza wa Jalla, nothing else. Here, my brothers and sisters in Islam, in order for your act of worship to be valid, you should have Tawheed. You should have Tawheed. You should be a mu'min, a believer in Allah Azza wa Jalla. If you are not a believer in Allah Azza wa Jal, then whatever you fast, even if you fasted all your life, then there is no point for your fasting. If someone associating with Allah partners, then there is no point for his act of worship. Subhanallah. And here, my brothers and sisters in Islam, where that if someone out of arrogance belittled following the religion of Allah Azza wa Jal, and follow, of course, will follow something else. And those people, Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned about them. They might do righteous things in this life, but Allah Azza wa Jalla has said in the Quran about them, وَقَدِمْنَا إِلَى مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمِلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ هَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. We came of all their deeds that they have done, and Allah Azza wa Jalla will make it like dust in the wind in the day of judgment. Nothing will remain of it. Why? Because the root of all of the action of worship, it has to be Tawheed. And Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, can you imagine the Messenger Alayhi Salatu Wasallam? Allah Azza wa Jal is saying to him, warning him, Alayhi Salatu Wasallam, And if Allah warned him, what about us as other Muslims? Allah said in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ وَإِلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ. It was revealed to you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to the people before you, which means Allah has warned the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the prophets before him, all of them. لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَعْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. If you associate with Allah partners, all your deeds will be invalid, and you're going to be amongst the losers in the Day of Judgment. This is a warning from Allah Azza wa Jal to all prophets of Allah, ending with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal accepts from those who have taqwa, who fears Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah will not accept the deeds of the people if they don't worship Allah Azza wa Jal. And here, they might have it in this life. They might have it in this life. They might have what they want in this life. But in the Day of Judgment, they will have nothing if they died without worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal alone with no partners. And the act of worship, any act of worship, including fasting, it has to be according to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we said before, here in this masjid, and I will repeat, for any act of worship, it should have two conditions. The first condition, sincerity. It has to be for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. Secondly, it has to be in the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You cannot elevate a way of fasting the way that you think. You cannot add. You cannot say, you know what, instead of breaking my fast on Maghrib, I want to break my fast on Isha. It is more time. I can do more time. Or to say, for example, I want to break my fast, for example, on Asr. It is easier, etc. All these things are invalid in Islam. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned this clearly in the Quran, that Allah Azza wa Jalla has written in this ummah that if the way it wasn't in the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it will be rejected. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَنْ عَمِلَ عَمَلًا لَيْسَ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرُنَا فَهُوَ رَدْ. Whoever did an act of worship, it doesn't follow our way, our methodology, then it is rejected. It is rejected. And the third thing, we need to understand, the more the tawheed is perfect in your heart, the more your act of worship will be more perfect. And exactly, this is the principle. That includes fasting. People who have issues in their tawheed, and sometimes people, they will say, but I worship none but Allah Azza wa Jal, and I follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What about showing off? And that's kind of hypocrisy in the heart of the people. And it could happen. Which means the root of your act of worship, which is tawheed, you are doing things not for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And if there is no, if you do the things as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yasiru al-riya'a, al-shirk al-asghar. Some of the showing off, it is the minor shirk. And what will happen to that? That will invalidate the deeds. But if there is a lot of riya'a, if you are doing everything just to please the people, not to please Allah Azza wa Jal, and those people, those are the hypocrites, which Allah Azza wa Jal has warned them severely. And their punishment is worse than the punishment of the people who associate with Allah partner. Allah said in the Quran, those munafiqeen and munafiqat, they will be in the lowest part of the hellfire. Why? Because they, all their act of worship is to show off. Which means there is no tawheed in their heart. They might practice Islam, apparently, but inside them is a pure shirk, pure kufr. And as well, for the people as well who are showing off, yes, maybe Allah Azza wa Jal might pardon them and forgive them if they seek forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal, but yet that will invalidate their righteous deeds if they are doing some righteous deeds to show off. So here, my brothers and sisters in Islam, we need to understand, the more tawheed is in your heart is firm, the more your act of worship is acceptable by Allah Azza wa Jal. And the more you make it perfect, the more your act of worship are perfect. And this is the idea behind it. So that's why we are fasting for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. We should understand that before we rectify our matters of fasting, before we rectify this, we should rectify our tawheed. We should rectify our tawheed first. Before you are asking about does the vaccine break the fast or not? Akhi, you're talking about vaccine. You're talking about breaking your fast or not. And where you, subhanallah, and you are hanging, Ya Rasulallah, on your house. Asking other than Allah Azza wa Jal. Asking Ya Jibreel, Ya Ali, in your house. And you say about the breaking the fast, subhanallah. Before you rectify these things, you have to rectify the tawheed first. Then after that, these things will be rectified. Subhanallah. And that's why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, you'll find some Sahaba, they talked about it even before. They said, they're talking about the fitrah, the natural disposition. That when you have fitrah, when you have pure fitrah, you are upon the fitrah, upon the pure disposition, the natural disposition that Allah has created you, monotheist person, worshipping Allah Azza wa Jalla alone. Then all these things, it will come as trivial. It will be easy for you. And as well, my brothers and sisters, fasting from the things that it will perfect our tawheed as well. It will perfect our tawheed. Why? Because it contains sincerity if you are sincere to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And as well, you are watching your things. And you are knowing that Allah Azza wa Jalla is watching you. That's why when the Salaf and the Sahaba, they were talking about, for example, when you fast, let your ear fast with you, let your eyes fast with you, let your tongue fast with you. Why do they say this? Because here, if you wanted to perfect your act of worship, if you want to perfect it, you have to do it properly. And you have to do it sincerely for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. What is the point? What is the point of someone that he is doing all muharramat in the day of Ramadan, while he is fasting or she is fasting? And they say, you know, I didn't eat and drink all the day. Subhanallah. What about the old haram that you do all these things throughout the day? That's why, my brothers and sisters, from the things that will rectify as well, it will make perfect our tawheed, that as well fasting. Because here the fasting, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Qudsi, that kullu amal ibn Adam, all the action of the son of Adam belongs to him, except fasting belongs to me. وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِهِ أَنَا reward upon it. Why the Prophet ﷺ has narrated this hadith from Allah Azza wa Jal to show that Allah Azza wa Jal is honoring tawheed, is honoring fasting above all other acts of worship. And Allah Azza wa Jal honor those who are fasting, because no one will know about you. You are truly fasting for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal except Allah Azza wa Jal. And the Prophet ﷺ, he said alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, رُبَّ صَائِمٍ حَظُهُ مِنْ صِيَامِهِ الْجُوعُ وَالْعَطَسِ. He said, someone who was fasting, he only gained from his fasting by being thirsty and being hungry, that's all. And my brothers and sisters, that one of the things as well about the tawheed, that from the barakat of tawheed, that Allah Azza wa Jal, as Ibn al-Qayyim has mentioned, that the more you abstain yourself from your desire, the more you abstain yourself from your desire, the more you're coming close to Allah Azza wa Jal. The more you stay away from your desire, and if you are sincerely for doing this for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, and your desire, the desire of the food, the desire of the drink, the desire of the sexual intimacy, from the morning until the evening, from the sunrise until the sunset, then the more you are closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. Closer to Allah Azza wa Jal. And that it will revive your spirit and becoming close to Allah Azza wa Jalla. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوج المستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام الأتمان الأكملان على محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My brothers and sisters in Islam, that the tawheed in our heart, it it will strengthen our act of worship. The tawheed that we practice, it will strengthen our act of worship. And it will rectify it. If we have some gaps and some shortcomings, it will rectify it. And there is a beautiful hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, this hadith authenticated by Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah, which is famous known hadith al-Bitaqa, hadith the card. A man, he will be brought in front of Allah Azza wa Jal. He will be brought to Allah Azza wa Jal. And he will have 99 of scrolls filled with sins. 99. Each one as much as his sight could reach to the horizon. Each scroll. All the way to the horizon as much as his sight could reach. And 99 of them of sins. Then they will say, Allah will ask him, did you do any righteous deeds? He will say, oh Allah, no, I haven't. Then Allah will say, today you will be not oppressed. Then it will be brought a card written on it, La ilaha illallah. That he has said it and act upon it sincerely from his heart. Then Allah Azza wa Jal will command, and then this card will be placed on one side of the scale, and the 99 scrolls filled of all of these sins. Then the card will overweigh and will overweight all the 99 scrolls, and then they will fly. Because there is nothing equivalent to La ilaha illallah. Nothing equivalent to La ilaha illallah. That is the point, my brothers and sisters. That is the point. The topic of our khutbah today, it was about this. So when we do act of ibadah, we have to do it because we believe in La ilaha illallah. And we believe in Muhammad Rasulullah alayhi salatu wasalam. When we believe in La ilaha illallah, we negate all kind of divine except Allah Azza wa Jal. And we follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam in his way. And that includes the fasting. And that's why the more that Allah Azza wa Jal, that the reward for the people who are fasting, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he said Allah Azza wa Jal will make, Allah created a gate in Jannah called Ar-Rayyan, for those ones who are fasting for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And after they enter through that gate, then it will be closed. No one will enter after them. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jal has mentioned all the action of the son of Adam belongs to him except fasting belongs to me. Meaning that it is upon Allah Azza wa Jal to reward. As long as you have tawheed, pure tawheed in your heart. And as long as you practice this act of worship for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, then you will be amongst those which Allah Azza wa Jal has promised in the Day of Judgment. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. You will be amongst those who are patient. Where Allah Azza wa Jal has said, Allah will reward those who are patient with no any accountability in the Day of Judgment. We ask Allah to be amongst them. عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ أَمَرَكُمْ بِأَمْرٍ بَدَأَ بِهِ بِنَفْسِهِ وَثَنَّى بِمَلَائِكَةِ الْقُدْسِ فَقَالَ جَلَّ مَنْ قَائِلٍ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم، اشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأجل وأتم وأكبر. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استووا استقيموا اعتدوا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.